Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another episode of the Broadcasters Podcast. I'm your host, Isaac Cruz, a podcast produced by Ricardo Colonna and Christopher Diaz, hosted by me, your host, Isaac Cruz, and written by me, your host, Isaac Cruz. And today, we have my brother, who's been in a vlogging channel before, Juan Morales. Yeah. There you go.
Smoking weed. Silent, bro.
You smoking weed?
Yeah, bro, I was smoking. I need a bit. I got my shit up. Get a little bit chill, that's it.
So, what you been up to?
I've been working, I've been in New York City.
You work at a factory, right?
That's correct.
You work at a factory just building guns or something?
No. We're not able to say that. Don't say that.
Why?
Don't say that. You can say be factory, don't say dummy, whatever. Don't say nothing like that.
Anyway, so. So, how's your love life going?
How my life going?
Your love life. Love life.
My love life. Okay. She's alright. She's working right now. So, we're good.
I mean, I like someone, but you know. I guess I'm not like you.
Nah, bro, I'm not that special. It's just you have to focus what you want and you have to be yourself.
Yeah, but you know, it's hard, you know, with Puerto Rican females.
I know it's hard, I know that, but you have to always, like I told you, you always have to focus on you. And don't thinking about that, you know. Be happy. You got a long life to do. Don't walk in it.
Oh, no, I'm happy, but the thing is that I don't know. For me, when I like someone that's Puerto Rican, it's hard because what I've been through with Puerto Ricans. Are bad experiences, are not good experiences. So when I try hard with this one,
I know that's tough, but let me tell you, not woman, they say, no, you can't do that, bro. You don't think like that because the first time you like someone, he can mean to you, and then now you think that the woman's gonna be the same. It's not the same.
I like this girl. I think this girl is really nice and shit. I won't say name because I can't say name at all. But, you know.
Everyone got that time. You're gonna get your time.
Yeah, but. I don't know, really. I mean, how do you did it to impress your girl?
My wife.
Yeah, how do you did it? Explain to people how you did it.
That's a long story. Let me go get my room. Explain you everything.
So he's gonna explain everything, but he's gonna get inside and go for blood.
Yeah. Yeah, bro. Like I said, that's long stuff, bro. Let me tell you what. How I gonna do all that? If I tell you how I'm gonna start that.
But how do you did it though?
How I did like, me myself.
Knowing this Puerto Rican and you're Puerto Rican, how do you do it? Because I'm a Puerto Rican, but I have no game towards Puerto Rican females whatsoever.
Wait, why? I don't hear you.
All we did is just play this. What it did last time, I kind of have her play this game that in Spanish is called Trabalenguas.
That's always going to happen, right? Don't worry.
So, you know, I have her playing this silly game, and, you know.
Yeah, I don't know.
she responded. It was pretty good, but you know, I don't know how the game worked, you know.
It's probably because that's not the correct one.
But I don't know if this one's the correct one yet because I haven't even confessed her. I don't know.
Like I told you, you have to first start be friends. Then when you start being friends with her and you start talking and have fun or something nice, then when you done all that, then you say what you feel with her.
Yeah, but
always happen, bro.
But how do you deal with yours though? What do you did?
Alright, so my story with my girl was this. Alright, so I was dating someone before. Mm-hmm. Alright. And everything was good, whatever. Then when I'm flying to this state where I am right now, it stopped changing. It was like mad every single day, and I want to talk to me, whatever. So I done with her. But after me done with that girl, I see my girl before long time. And he always loved me. And he don't tell me he have feelings for me, never. All right. So what I done with my girl, well, my ex girl, whatever, I be like 2 months, 2 years for me, like alone. Then one day I was talking with one of friends, like first time, and then he joined my girl and I. So nothing, I said hey to him, whatever, we try have fun without talking. Then been like a 3 or 6 day, whatever, like something like that. I start talking with her, whatever, we got something special, man, you know. Mm-hmm. Then we start a date. To see no heat, to gather, guitar, whatever. So we go to the date, everything was good, everything was fun. Then after that, we start talking a lot.
I got a question for you. Do you ever had any threat? Do you have any threat from friends or anybody in her inner circle, entorno, that threat you for trying to talk to her? I just want to know because it happened to me, so I just want to know if I'm not the only one or if I'm crazy or whatever.
So you're talking about que me pasa lo que te pasa a ti.
Yeah, lo que me pasó a mí.
Yeah, in this sector right now.
Yeah, if it happens to you, si persona de soltero, no. You have the...
At first, some people don't like it. But after that, the same people don't like it. It changed their mind. And they friend with us. And yo, we got like 4 already together.
So they threat you before, for trying to talk to her. So I'm not going people. Crazy because I'm it's the only one that he haven't done me. I'm going crazy.
No. The problem is that people with don't know me. That's why he don't like me. When I seen that people, I start talking with him. Then he changed their mind. And then he told me, no, you like two people. I'll let you stay with me. That's the order.
Because it happened to me. The worst mistake I ever did was ask permission for talking. I don't know why I did that.
Let me tell you, that was stupid. I didn't have to ask for nothing.
Because I just wanted the person.
Listen, if you love someone, you don't have to go to the friend and tell her, yo, can I talk to your friend? Can I? She like me, whatever, no, bro. You're going straight to her. You don't have to ask no one.
Because I remember I went to him, I was like, hey, I want to talk to this girl, then blah, blah, blah. And again, I'm not saying name, but like, but this, that. And he goes, you know, I already told you this whole thing. And he goes, I'm going to translate it, but he goes, oh, you can talk to her all you want, but when I throw you with the crocodiles, then don't complain.
Nah, bro. You know what? Forget that conversation. Let me tell you something. How this going? How your dad going? How your podcast going? I've been a long time don't be here, bro. And I'm happy to be here. Just tell me how you been, bro.
I got a job already.
That's good.
That was a warehouse.
I'm proud of you.
Build warehouse. I work over the week from 4 to 12:30. I got weekends off and I go here on a podcast on the weekends. Adrian's supposed to come today on the air, but he didn't. My co-host, but he didn't answer. So I go, I'll do it with you.
Alright. Oh, it's fine, bro. Like I told you, I've been a long time. Remember that I leave for my music, do my all that, you know my story, bro.
I mean, you know, I just, I'm not stressing over it, man. I mean, I just think it's kind of ridiculous that you get threatened for trying to talk to someone. I mean, it's just stupid.
That's happened, bro. That's high school, bro. You have to understand in high school. Be like that, you got drama, bro.
You know, just. I don't know, I mean, it's just, I never, it's just the first time in my life that I get threatened for liking someone. Because it never happened to me before. The first time that ever happened to
me. Yeah, bro, that's crazy.
But, you know, I just keep talking to her and I don't give a fuck. Honestly, don't give a fuck.
You don't have to ask forward, bro.
I don't give a fuck. I just keep talking to her and shit.
Because
I talked to her, and when I talked to her, in the little bit that I talked to her, things go well. It's not like she ignored me or anything. Everything goes well. Yeah. It's not like. Not like she's ignoring me or anything. Plus, she's beautiful. I'm gonna send her a picture of her. I'm gonna send her a picture. So you and the assistant walking by, you can see her. She's beautiful. She's beautiful inside and outside. She got the two qualities on either.
She's right. Yo, I see you post about Donald Trump.
You complaining again because I didn't go to prom?
Nah, bro, I see that you post the president Donald Trump.
Oh.
I see that.
Yesterday was the prom, the high school prom. I didn't go.
You didn't go?
No, I didn't go. I didn't want to. You know me, I don't go to those things.
But you should go. I mean, you're too late already, but you.
Why would I want to?
Apart your dad, bro. That's something apart. What you are, because you're never gonna be in the school again. You're gonna.
I know,
get
but like.
Up, you know what I'm saying?
I know, but like.
I still got my photo, my video for the prom, bro. I still got all my stuff. Because I'm proud of who I am, bro. Because at the first, I was bullying.
By Puerto Ricans, right? I know. I understand you trying to get your bands up.
Tomorrow,
fuck that shit, girl, I don't need it. From the start, I've been out here fighting demons. I got all the answers. Baby, you a dancer. Shorty, she a cancer. So she ain't got no manners. You tomorrow, fuck that shit, girl, I don't need it. ¡Cómeme los huevos! ¡Cómeme los tú, hijo puta!
Me he encontrado esto, que me sirve como metáfora, ¿vale? No, hay que leerlo hacia adelante. Y míralo todo lo que te queda por vivir. ¡Vívelo! ¡No tengas miedo! ¡Deja el pasado atrás! ¡Hijo de puta!